and I go to run my code again, I should be able to see a whole bunch of stuff. So now you can see the speed at which I'm traveling at, the direction that I'm actually traveling, and also what my image angle is. What's up, everybody? Axe Wizard here. When last we left off, we got our background working, finally. So you can see that we are able to fly around. There's like a semi-transparent near background, and then we have the far background, and they move at different speeds, and it gives us like a really cool effect. I think it looks great. So I'm pretty happy with this. Now what I want to do is, I'm getting tired of looking at these weapons just hanging off in the middle of nowhere. So I'm going to update this to work better, but also what I want to do is I want to, instead of having to pop open the sprite and manually calculate where this stuff goes, I think I'm just going to set a debug draw event. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to create a variable, and I'm just going to say, I'm going to say debug stuff. And I'm going to create a variable called var, or no, no var, just a regular variable. And I'm going to say testing mode equals false. And so what I'm going to do is that in my step event, I still got a lot of code to clean up here too. Debug stuff, I'm going to say if keyboard check, I'm going to say released. And the key that I'm going to check for is going to be VK, which is like virtual key. And I'm just going to do F5. So that'll be like my debug mode key that I can press. Maybe that won't have any bad results. We'll see. So I'm going to say if testing mode, which is true, because it's a Boolean, so this sets true or false. So if true, then do this. If not, do something else. So I'm gonna say if testing mode equals true, then testing mode equals false. And I'm gonna add an else statement here, which is gonna catch if it's not true. And I'm gonna set testing mode to true. This is basically just a toggle. So I'm going to put toggle debug stuff. Boom. So now what I can do is that in my draw event, I can add some other stuff here. So I can say debug stuff. And we could say if testing mode. Then we can do a bunch of drawing stuff here. So what should we... So the main things that we have to get is the relative X and Y from where the ship origin is. So if I pop open my ships here, like, you know, I have like this ship here, this is the origin here. So if I pop open a grid, I was basically calculating where stuff would go from the center, but I kind of want to just do that by running the game and then being able to put my mouse where I think a weapon should go, and it will tell me what the relative X and Y is. All right, so how we're going to do that, we are going to say draw the relative X, Y, based on ship and mouse position. So what we're going to do is we're going to say var, we probably already have an XX. No, we don't. XX equals, and we're going to say our own X. So we want the difference. So say if our ship is here and our mouse is to the right of us, the mouse is going to have a greater value here, and we want to get that difference. So I think we want to subtract where the mouse is from our current position, and that will give us the right, like, sort of a direction that we need to go as well. So X, so we're going to say mouse X minus X. Okay, there we go. And this bar YY is just going to be mouse Y minus Y. So that'll give us our relative XY coordinates of where we need to set that. So now that we've calculated that, we want to draw text, and we're going to say, I'm just going to say mouse X, mouse Y. I want to draw it on my cursor, and I'm just going to make a nice string here. So we're going to say relative X, we're going to do plus, and we're going to, since you can't add anything else to a string but strings, we're going to make sure that XX is a string. Then we're going to add on to that as well. And we're going to do a new line. And we're going to say relative Y, the space after, plus string. We're going to stringify this. And we're going to say YY. And then we need a closing parenthesis here. There we go. So now if I save this and I change my... Let me go in here, and what I'm going to do is I'm just going to disable all my weapons for right now, because I want to be able to put them in better spots. So I'm just going to disable them for right now. That way I can see everything on my ship. And okay, so if I hit F5 to toggle my debug mode. So say if I wanted to put a gun like right here. There we go. It gives me my relative X and Y. I don't know if the Y... Yeah, that's perfect. So we'll say 62 minus 12, right? Cool. So let's just do SCR weapon. We'll do another weapon light cannon. And it was what, 61... Oh crap, I don't remember. I should have wrote it down. Let me run it again. Let me toggle my debug mode. So 61 minus 12. I'm going to keep it running, that way I don't have to keep starting it every time. 61 minus 12. And then I also want to put one like right... like right here, and this is gonna be 6113. So let's go back to Game Maker here. We'll do another SCR. I need to add a comma after this because we are in a in array weapon. SCR weapon. We'll do another weapon light cannon. And we're going to do 61. It was 13, I think it was. Boom. So now I'm going to close this. I'm going to run this again. And this should create weapons. There we go. Now they're on our ship. And it looks a little better than just hanging out in the middle of nowhere. So that's pretty cool. Now, where should I add a turret? I'm thinking like right here would be a pretty cool spot for a turret on this ship. Because it looks like it could support one. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to... I'm going to start it again. That way my ship isn't rotated at all. I'm going to hit debug mode. And right about here. So -7331. -7331. -7331. Save. Oh, Yeah, stop the current thing and then run it again. Oh, see, I forgot to put a comma here. So we have compile errors down here. I don't think we've run into two compile errors yet. There we go. There we go. Cool. So now I have a turret on my ship and it looks a lot more natural than it did before. We can do some damage. Sweet. So that brings up a good point though, of something that we're going to want to account for in the future, is that I think every ship type should have a set number of armaments that it can carry. So basically like weapon slots. So like this one, like I might be able to put like, I don't know, maybe two more weapons that are directional, and it's only got a spot for maybe one turret. So this works fine now, but later on, I can't just keep adding weapons to it. I have to define where this stuff is going to go. So what I'm thinking is that I can do is that maybe I can just determine where the ship armaments are. And I'll have to do some thinking on how I want to do that. I'm not going to tackle that tonight because that is a bad idea to try to tackle when it's basically almost midnight. So that's good to go there. That works a lot better, I think. So now we have like a little debug mode where we can write stuff. So I think that's cool. I think we should also include some other debug mode stuff too. So I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to take this stuff and I'm going to say var msg equals for message. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to keep adding more stuff onto this message, and I can just keep like adding new lines and stuff to it. And so I think what I might do now is I might just say, what else do I want to track? Maybe I want to track my speed. So message equals message plus. And I'm going to keep adding more stuff to this string. I don't want it to just be one super long string. I can do it piecemeal. I can build it and then I can just draw one big string here. So what I might do is I might just say, we're going to have a new line here. So N, let's see, I'm going to say speed and we're just going to do a string. And we're going to say speed plus, going to do a new line, direction. Oops, I didn't mean to close that string yet. Direction plus string direction. There we go. I think I might have one parenthesis too many. There we go. And then I can just add more stuff onto it as well. So we can do relative XY. We can do speed and direction. We can do, we can do like number of weapons, or we can even do, image angle, MSG equals MSG plus a string. We'll start with a new line, image angle, and we can just do plus string, image angle. There we go. So now if I save this and I go to run my code again, I should be able to see a whole bunch of stuff. So now you can see the speed at which I'm traveling at, the direction that I'm actually traveling, and also what my image angle is. It's interesting that it goes negative. So if I keep rotating, I wonder if it just keeps going and going and going. That is really interesting. I did not know the image angle keeps going up and up and up. So let's see what, I'm gonna try to travel this way and see if the direction goes negative as well. It doesn't, it just goes back to like 359. That's interesting. So I think GameMaker has a built-in function to handle that. So the image angle, like I've rotated a bunch apparently. But yeah, this is interesting. So there we go. I've got some debug information that I can view, and I can easily toggle that back off, and then we're good to go. Maybe I might actually just put this in debug mode as well. For now, I might want to make that a permanent thing, especially if I get outside the bounds of the room. I might want to draw that, but for now, draw arrow back to the center of the room. So if I save this, should be able to hit F5 and it should show us the arrow back to the room. So if we get lost, boom, look at that. Now I know where to go. Neat. Pretty happy with that. We're almost to the part now where we could start doing some fun stuff. And by fun stuff, I mean tackling enemy AI. But I think the next big thing that I have to tackle is I want to figure out how to handle basically plotting weapon points on a ship. So I think that's the next big thing that I'm going to probably tackle later. But for this episode, we just did a little bit of cleanup, rearranged our weapons, and then we did some debug stuff. So I think this is a nice short, sweet episode after the long ones I've just done previously. So sorry, but this is real game development. You don't know what you don't know until you don't know it. And when you don't know it, you got to find a solution for it. And that is oftentimes a bit messy, but it's a bit fun, I think. So yeah, this is a pretty game. Like compared to what it was, like, are you kidding me? Like if I set this back to my old placeholder sprites, it's like a night and day difference. Speaking of which, I should probably get like a different sprite for my cursor too. But anyway, thank you all so much for watching, and I really do appreciate all the support that you guys have shown me in the comments. I honestly didn't expect anybody to really watch any of this stuff, and the fact that I've got multiple people who are excited for these episodes to come out blows my mind, especially after the last few. I'm so sorry. But I'm really excited to get into the more fun stuff, because right now we're kind of taking care of all these little details, but it's gonna really start coming to life when we start, you know, programming these ships to fight back, and just programming regular AI behavior, and, you know, make it so we can land on planets, and we can buy resources, we can harvest asteroids, and go on quests and stuff. Maybe we can have escort ships to help us fight. You know, maybe I can make a big carrier class ship that one of the weapons, it just actually launches more fighter ships. Kind of like a Protoss carrier from StarCraft. Like, I think that'd be cool. I think that'd be awesome. So I'm all about it. I'm hyped. I cannot wait to get into more fun stuff. But again, I think we got to take care of some of these details first to make this all work, but just glad I got people enjoying it with me. Catch you guys next time.